But I'm just...
Welcome to another episode of the Untitled Podcast.
Let's discuss Lana Del Rey.
What you are about to hear is deeply disturbing.
Elvis is my daddy, Marilyn's my mother, Jesus is my bestest friend. Will you still love me when I'm no longer young and beautiful? I will love you till the end of time. Boy, look at you, looking at me. I know you don't understand. You could be a bad motherfucker, but that don't make
me head on the unmade bed while the limousines wait in the street. Dying young and playing hard. That's the way my father made his life an art.
When anyone finds out that I like Lana Del Rey, they assume it's a physical thing. And I'll tell you, she's fucking gorgeous. That's coincidental to the fact that I like her music a lot. And I like it for thematic, melancholy, glamorous, tragic, mid-century American pop culture. Kind of all the things you would do if you were an artist and you had the money to do them.
Pussy tastes like Pepsi Cola. My eyes are white like cherry pies. I got a taste for men who are older. It's always been so, it's no surprise. Harvey's in the sky with diamonds and he's making me crazy.
Broadly is dream pop or baroque pop. I don't know what I would call it. It's in the realm of Cocteau Twins, Julie Cruz, Chris Isaak, Anna Calvi, This Mortal Coil, maybe even Lord, Bat for Lashes, and definitely Blonde Redhead, based on the minimalist sounds that somewhat go together. And the sound is of depression. It's gorgeous. It's beautiful. But it ain't sugar and spice and everything nice. And that's why I'm drawn to it.
Lost, but now I am found. I can see her once I was blind. I was so confused as a little child. Trying to take what I could get. Scared that I couldn't find all the answers I need. Don't make me sad. Love is not enough and the road gets tough. I don't know why. Keep making me laugh. Let's go get high. The road is long, carry on.
So she was born Elizabeth Grant in 1985 in New York City to an upper-class family, which means she was rich. And she had taken her career into her own hands in a way by making demos and recording things, starting bands, writing her own songs. Just sort of had a DIY ethic. And she ended up with a video that she made called Video Games. And she made the video for it, and it got several zillion hits on iTunes.
I tell you all the time, heaven is a place on earth with you. Tell me all the things you want to do. I heard that you like the bad girls, honey. Is that true? It's better than I ever even. Built for two, only worth living if somebody is loving you. Maybe now you do. Now you do.
And next thing you know, there's a buzz about her. And because she has connections, I'm sure, and because of the buzz, she gets invited to perform on Saturday Night Live without an album out.
Once again, Lana Del Rey.
Blue jeans, white shirt, walked into the room, you know you made my eyes burn. It was like James Dean, for sure. You're so fresh to death and sick as kid cancer.
And she doesn't do very well. I've watched it. It's not a train wreck. It's not the worst thing you've ever seen. She was clearly nervous, and her voice took a minute to get there. Yeah, she just kind of stood there and sang, but I wouldn't expect her to do anything else. I mean, I really don't see dancers in this show.
Drive fast. I can almost taste it now. L.A. I don't even have to fake it now. You were like so sick. Everybody said it. You were way ahead of the trend. Get it. Elvis is the best. Hell yes. Honey, put on that party dress. Like ooh, ooh, ooh. Ooh, 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 ooh. You made me crazy. You made me wild. Just like a baby.
I thought we had a morning session, but we're glad you could make it.
Is it morning?
No, not at all. Anyway, congrats on the latest single. It's doing great. I love how it's all about the West Coast.
Which song are you talking about?
Exactly.
We both know that it's not fashionable to love me.
It's been said that this young woman is a huge gift to critics because, you know, it stirs up that debate. The postmodern irony of this character she's invented, the post-feminism of her retro 40s, 50s tough dame throwback character, the question of authenticity, and none of it is really worth getting into because the bottom line is she's boring. Cocktail lounge schmaltz. And this tired routine from her
You're a fucking disgrace.
Could it be that Lana is not politically correct enough for them?
Don't call Lana Del Rey a feminist. The West Coast singer admits she doesn't really care for talking politics when it comes to women's rights. Whenever people bring up feminism, I'm like, God.
Rock veteran Kim Gordon has renewed her assault on singer Lana Del Rey. Gordon tells Mojo magazine, "Lana Del Rey, I really don't like her. Her comments about feminism, anyone can do whatever they want. You still have to take responsibility for your personal actions as a female."
She's influenced by Allen Ginsberg and Leonard Cohen and David Lynch. And then you also have this sort of love for dangerous and dark and weird and unknown. She's a part of that.
Out on that open road, you can be my full-time daddy while I'm gone, singing blues has been getting old. You can be my full-time baby hot or cold. Don't break me down. I've been traveling too long. I've been trying too hard. With one pretty song. I hear the birds on the summer breeze. I drive fast.
Did an album called Sirens. It's unreleased. It was demos. Lana did it under the pseudonym of Male Jailer. You can find that on YouTube. It was composed entirely of acoustic tracks, so I would have might like to check that out.
Well, I pawned the earrings that you gave me. I saw them all.
So a little controversy arose from the fact that in 2010, she had her own album pulled from distribution. The album was called Lana Del Rey, and David Kahn had a part in it, but I don't know what the reasoning was other than maybe they wanted to get on message so much about her look and general posture as an artist. But I started noticing a lot of female artists that I was enjoying having that ethereal kind of feel to them. There were even a couple of Madonna songs that I like that have that, and in fact I really love those. If those were like her career, I'd be on board, not there for the rest of it.
In the land of gods and monsters, I was an angel, looking to get fucked hard, like a groupie incognito posing as a real singer.
And then she put out Born to Die in 2012, and that's her first official album. That's when she also did a music video for Blue Velvet with proper homage to the movie.
Blue velvet, blue. stars.
Then she put out an EP called Paradise, which is the best single item to own of hers so far. Really great, great songs. Much more accomplishment as far as the writing level that she's trying to hit. Now, my favorite full-length album is Ultraviolence, and that dropped in 2014. It immediately went to number one, and she and Dan Auerbach from the Black Keys worked on it, and they say they're excited to present you Ultraviolence. Don't know where Ultraviolence comes from. It's a really cool word. It comes from A Clockwork Orange.
Down on the west coast, I get this feeling like it all could happen. That's why I'm leaving you for the moment. You for the moment, boy blue. Yeah, you. You pull it hard up the shore. I'm feeling hot to touch. You say you miss me. You say I miss you so much.
We just do a take. Lana Del Rey, Mermaid Parade, take one.
Driving with my top down, palm trees pour me, nuclear winter is here.
Cut. That was great, Lana. So were you just warming up there?
I'm never warm.
Right. Somebody get Lana a scarf.
And my boyfriend's in a band. He plays guitar while I sing Lou Reed. I've got feathers.
So she was pretty busy that year. Like, she performed three songs at Kim and Kanye's pre-wedding celebration at the Palace of Versailles. According to sources, Kanye is rumored to have paid Lana Del Rey $2.8 million. But she says she did it for free.
Cause if I had my way, you would always stay. And I'd be your tiny dancer, honey. I waited for you in the spot you set away. In the city on the park bench, in the middle of the boring rain. I just wanted things to be the same. You said to meet me up there tomorrow, but tomorrow never came. Tomorrow never came.
I'm ready.
All right, energy's up. Take two, hit it.
I've got a beer and a mermaid's trail.
Those aren't the lyrics. And are those beans in your mouth?
They're my singing beans.
And then Lust for Life came out just this past summer, July. It's the first project that she's put out in 2 years. It has special guests on it, like Rocky, A$AP Rocky, some rapper dude, The Weeknd, Stevie Nicks, and Sean Lennon. Just an all-star cast there, folks.
You have the personality of a wet paper towel, and all the characters in your songs read like a trashy romance novel. Records and only seems to be infatuated with old things simply because they're old. This record is just gross. It is dying to be tragic. It is dying to be meaningful.
So I'm wondering if this album becomes her version of Rock of the Westies, meaning something conceived that structurally looks like the same thing. But that means she's going to have some bad rapping on the record. And man, I hate that shit. It rarely works in a crossover. And usually it really just is an embarrassment. You know, I've listened to the record. I've heard that. I really haven't gone back to it. Let you know how the level of my interest in it based on these things. It just sounds less inspired and less spunky. I'm missing atmosphere. I'm missing the dark, where now I'm getting like the beach. Hey, I like the beach, but fuck.
Why look at you looking at me? I know you know how I feel. Loving you's hard, being here's harder. You take the wheel. I don't wanna do this anymore. It's so surreal. I can't survive if this is all that's real. All I wanna do is get high. Better beach, get high. Better beach, get high. Boy, look at you looking at me. I know you don't understand. You now you're just another one of my problems, because you got out of hand. We won't survive.
So it remains to be seen what's going to be next with this young lady. She's got it all going for her right now, and I hope she does not fuck up. If for some chance Lana Del Rey heard this, just don't mess up. Just don't do stupid shit. You know what it is. Just don't do it. You'll live to be several more years, and you'll be a legend.
Produced by Donnie Shattuck.
Heaven Cheese Films presents the Lana Del Rey Holiday Album, featuring classic hits like
Silent Night, Holy Night, Sugar Plums Dancing in the Pale Moonlight, I Love Sleigh Bells, White Sand, Take My Body Downtown in This Winter Wonderland,
Diet Mountain Dew, Happy Birthday Jesus, My Pepsi Cola Pussy is the sweetest. Do you think I'll burn in hell for this tune? Do you think I'll burn in hell? Cause I'm crazy, Santa's lazy, I need hot turkey to save me.
Lana Del Rey Holiday Album. Get yours today.
Christmas time and it's fucking cold.